Good morning, YouTube. Today, we're going to change the oil in my Ferrari 458. So the Ferrari 458 is just getting old enough where some of them are starting to come off the original factory maintenance program. So they came with a 7-year maintenance contract. So obviously this is a 2010, so it's 9 years old. It is no longer under the original maintenance contract. So that means I either got to start paying for oil from a dealership or an independent place, or I can do it myself. And the do-it-yourself, there is an awesome option which makes it really easy, which is through Recambio America, which they did sponsor this video. So they sent me this oil change kit. All the oil change stuff you need is really easy. All you have to do is order one part number. It is the part number 458OCK. So that's a 458 oil change kit. So it comes with, the 458 actually has one of these canister filters. We've got the O-ring for the canister filter. And then we've got a drain plug and three crush washers. Yeah, there's actually three drain plugs on the 458. So there's two on the sump pan and then one for the actual sump. So this is a dry sump car, which means it's got a lot of oil and you drain it out from a lot of different spots. And by the way, you check the oil while the engine is running, while the oil is warmed up. We're gonna get the car warmed up, put it back into the garage, get it up on jacks, and then we gotta start removing the underbody panel to get access to the engine so we can drain the oil. Hopefully this one has smaller drain plugs that don't dump out the oil quite as fast as the 430. Ah! Son of a bitch. Maybe we won't make an absolute disaster. So we're gonna let the 458 warm up for a little bit. That way it's got the oil a little bit thinner. It's gonna be flowing out easier. And any sort of contaminants in the oil should be picked up off the bottom of the pan and then suspended in the oil so it gets that out of the system. At least that's the theory. I don't know if it actually matters. Technically it should expand everything so the bolts will come out a little easier. But that also means we'll probably burn ourselves, which, that's the downside. There's always a positive and negative, you know?
Nah, he got the upside, I got the downside. See, there's two sides to every schwarm.
Okay, so I let it warm up until the temperature gauge was about 120, 130 degrees, so it's just a little bit warm. It's not like gonna nuclear grade burn me. Now we gotta get it up in the air. We're gonna have to pull off the bottom under tray, and then we can get access to the oil plugs. On this car, since it does have the cartridge filter, the filter is not underneath the car. It's actually right there in the valley between the intake runners, so a little bit easier to get access to. Hopefully makes this a lot cleaner. All right, so we're gonna get my quick jack set up. So there's a jack point that's kinda in there, and it's actually pretty far in, and then the jack point on the front of the car is actually right at the front, just behind the wheels. So it makes it a little bit tricky to get these quick jacks positioned in the correct spot. In fact, I'm actually gonna have to turn these around, I think, since I have it backwards. All right, got the quick jacks in place, connected. It's always best to kind of raise it a tiny bit, make sure it's in the right position, and then raise it all the way. So kind of give it a little bit of a lift and take a peek. All right, looks pretty good under there. We'll continue raising the car. Cool. So one of the things that I kind of don't like about working on a Ferrari versus most other cars is anytime you want to do anything on the underside of the car, you have like a ton of these 10 mm bolts you got to take out to get access to the under tray panel. That's how many bolts there are holding the under tray panel up. It's kind of a pain in the butt. So the only thing that sucks about the quick jacks is now that the car is up, I have to put it back down so I can get the under tray out of the way. And it's still better than having to jack it up, jack it down, and all that stuff, but still kind of a pain in the butt. So to lower the car, I need to raise it first. That way it takes the pressure off of the control arms or the lift arms. And now we can let it down. Alright, we're gonna remove the diffuser because I think I can't get the under tray off without this off. There we go. All right, so I run into a snag, which is that there are these air ducts in front of the rear wheels that kind of go way up into the car. These air ducts are actually attached to the bottom tray thing. I think there's only like 3 or 4 bolts, but they go up so high that now that it's undone, I actually can't get them out. So I need to somehow get in there and unscrew these bolts, detach these air ducts, and then I can get the diffuser out of the way. So I was gonna have to do a little bit of a ninja kind of twisting my arm in contorted ways to do this. Next time, while I have the car up, we'll have to disconnect these. So I think the proper order of operations is undo the bolts that you can on the sides before lifting the car up, then lift the car up, undo all the bolts, including the bolts for these air ducts, then drop the car back down, then get the bottom panel out of the way. Good to know for next time. So you can see here's the air duct. Well, maybe you can't see because it's so dark, but it's got 4 bolts, 4 10 mils on the bottom. Okay, there we go. Got the stupid panel out of the way. Now we have to lift the car again. Yay. Ugh, this is definitely harder than the 430. Here is the sump drain plug, which we're gonna do this last because it's gonna have the most oil. And then you can see here is the drain plugs right there and right there. So we'll pull those two first. All right, let's see if I can, missed. Not too bad. Well, that's good. There's no metal shavings on the plug, so that's a good sign. Certainly seems to come out with less force than the 430, so that's good. All right, so while we're waiting for that one. All right. Oh, that's funny. The O-ring's still there. And the crush washer, there it goes. The crush washer was still there. Hopefully we won't get too big a splash. Not too bad. Okay, let's get rid of the old crush washer. These are basically done draining. I've let them drain for quite a while. So we'll have to put back on the drain plugs with the new crush washers. These get torqued down to 60 newton meters, which is about 45 foot-pounds. So we will set that on the torque wrench. Get my plug started. Okay, got my torque wrench set. All right, 60 newton meters again. Now we got the sump drain plug. This one is a 22 millimeter plug. Now this one's got a lot of oil in there, so it's gonna really come out. And hopefully we can not splash it everywhere. It's already starting to leak. Oh, this will be fun. One more. Woo! All right, not too bad. It's coming out with force, man. All right, let's let that drain for a little while. We're down to a little drizzle, so we'll put in the new plug. Actually, the kit comes with a new Hill Engineering plug, so I don't even have to reuse the old one. And of course, a new crush washer. All right, again, we're gonna torque these down to 60 newton meters, which is about 45 foot-pounds. Jeez. We are done on the bottom. So we got the oil drained. Now we just gotta do the oil filter. I'm gonna leave the bottom panel off while we do the oil filter, just in case I drop a wrench or something, because then I'll have to pull the panel anyway. So let's just leave it off and then button it all up when we're all done. Let's drop the car, pull the oil filter, and replace it. So the oil filter is right down there. It's a 32 millimeter socket, and actually I don't have a 32 millimeter socket, so I'm gonna have to order one. What I'm gonna do instead is I'm gonna use my oil filter generic thing and see if that'll work. Hopefully it will. There. So I separated the old oil filter. Gotta get off the old O-ring. There we go. Put on the new one. Clean this up while we're at it. Now the new oil filter just kind of pops in just like that. That's it. Pretty easy. Let's get the new filter in there. The cap is supposed to be torqued down to 25 newton meters. Since I don't have a socket, I'm gonna have to wing it for now and then get a socket later. The good news is it's got an O-ring, so, now it's tight. There, I think that's all we need on that. Before we put the bottom tray on, I'm gonna dump in about 9 quarts of oil, just enough to kind of get it full, mostly full. It's 10 quarts total, just to make sure it doesn't leak. All right, we got 9 quarts of Pennzoil 5W40 in there. So now we're gonna jack it up, put the bottom tray back on, and then we're gonna start it up, let it warm up, and then check the oil and probably add that last quart. So it is a 10 quart system. I just like to be on the safe side and start with 9 just in case. You do not wanna overfill these. It's very bad to overfill these cars. So I'd rather be slightly low than slightly high. While I got the bottom tray off, I wanted to show you. So that hole right there is where your jack point is. So you can see the tray's actually really far forward. Right now I'll end up way back here under the engine. But that exposes a piece of frame that you can put your jack on. So you probably need a hockey puck or something. You don't want to jack it over here. The frame actually kind of like comes back and then curves in like this. So if you jack it out here, you're not going to be jacking on the frame and you're going to damage your car. All right, got the bottom tray back on and the diffuser back on. We just got to drop it down, start it up, warm it up, and check the oil. Okay, Ferrari's back on the ground. We're all set. So first thing I'm going to do is reset the computer for the service interval. So in order to do that, you do have to have a special computer. You can't just do it within the dashboard. I bought the Launch X431. I'll put a link in the description below if you want to buy one of these. They're not cheap. You're going to be talking close to $1,000. Mine was a little less than that. And I did test it already to make sure it can actually do this. So I've already reset the service interval, but I'm going to reset it again just for you guys. All right, so I booted up my little launch little tablet. It's pretty cool. It's got an ODB2 Bluetooth reader on the back. So you just kind of pop it out. And now I need to plug this into the OBD port. All right, I plugged it into the ODB port. We'll turn the key forward so that the ignition is on. All right, it's gonna bark about a couple of things and stuff. So we go into the launch application, the X431 application. All right, we're gonna go into traditional diagnose. We're gonna go find Ferrari. And Ferrari version, oops. Click on that. Okay, connected. That's good. Go find 458 Italia. F142, gasoline. So, system selection. We're going to go to instrument cluster. We're going to go to special functions. Reset service. So, we're going to hit the reset service. Okay. Function executed. So, procedure is complete. All right, we can exit. Now, on my dashboard, we're gonna go to main menu setup, go down to service. And you can see it's showing nothing because it's reset. So we just need to wait for the oil temperature to come up before we check the oil. So it needs to come up a little bit. The oil temp is up about 170, something like that. So we can now check the oil. Alright, so check the oil. You gotta remove the cap. Wipe off any oil that's on the stick. Check it back in, make sure it sits all the way down. And pull it out. And you can see it's right there at the lower dot. So the difference between this dot and this dot is 1 quart. So we need to add that last quart. We added that quart. Let's check it again.
actually, it's still only about 3/4 of the way up, but that is good enough. So we are all set to go.
We're all done with the 458 oil change. As you can see, it's not terribly difficult. Maybe slightly more difficult than the 430 only because you have one more drain plug and the bottom tray is a little bit complicated. Although, interesting enough, the bottom tray is really sturdy, so it doesn't flex as much, which actually makes it a little bit easier to reinstall. It's so sturdy that you could kind of push it up from like kind of the midpoint and it wouldn't flex terribly bad, so you could actually get the screws and, you know, the bolts in place and basically just kind of work one side at a time, get it kind of tilted up, and then pick up the other side and do that. 10 quarts of Pennzoil 5W40, 3 crush washers, and the oil filter, and the oil filter O-ring. That's all you need. Recambi of America sponsored this video. They sent me their oil change kit. That part number is 458OCK. So that's 458OCK, the 458 oil change kit. Pretty awesome because it just comes with everything you need and then you're all set. Obviously the missing part is the computer. So you either need to find someone who's got one of these computers or get someone who's gonna reset the service indicator. I mean, you don't have to, but then you're gonna have the car barking at you about changing the oil. Oil's all good, should be good for about 12,000 miles, which is crazy. We'll see what the oil looks like in a couple thousand miles. Had to get this in because we're about to do a big road trip. So you're gonna wanna stay tuned for that. It's gonna be awesome. In the meantime, subscribe, like, and share this video. You need to go subscribe to Recambi's channel. So they have their own YouTube channel. Link is in the description below. Also go visit their Instagram page. They post some really cool pictures of Ferraris. And if you didn't know, we actually have a contest going. So one of you is gonna win a $50 gift card. All you have to do is tag Recambi America and post on Instagram, follow them. And we're gonna just randomly choose someone who followed them and followed me. So pretty cool, huh? All right, guys, we're gonna be doing a lot of car stuff. You're gonna wanna stay tuned. It's gonna be sweet.